In the video series, the 6-part video series about applying for jobs, in one of the episodes, I talked about or asked a question to you guys. Why do you want to be a network engineer? Really, what is your motivation for wanting to be a network engineer and not a server administrator or a security engineer or a doctor? So I want to hear from you guys what your answer would be, and then I would provide you my answer, which I would do now. But let me share with you some of the great answers that I got for that question. So one of them was by Polychronio, and he wanted to be a network engineer because he loves routers more than servers because it connects to the internet. And he thinks that the internet is all about connections. And here's another one by Lopless Music. He has always had a passion for technology. And one of the reasons why he got into the IT field, it didn't happen until his first job when he went into, or he saw the first switch room, the wiring closet, and he fell in love. Since that moment, he has been intrigued with how networking works. That emotion later changed to excitement. And he's currently pursuing his dream to become a Cisco network engineer by studying for the CCNA. He loves everything about Cisco and the learning process and the late nights trying to master something that you don't understand. So that's why he wants to become a Cisco network engineer. Or this one by Michael Norris. There are a lot of reasons why I want to be a network engineer. Mostly because I enjoy designing and troubleshooting on large scale basis. It also seems like a very remarkable trait to learn. The world's communication traffic is changing very rapidly and will require skilled engineers to design and maintain. Network infrastructure is essentially the backbone of any corporate, government, or educational entity's communication structure. So those are very, very great answers. And really, my answer is very similar to what you guys said. You guys said it very, very nicely, though. So let me get you very quickly why I wanted to be a network engineer. And I have a professional reason and a personal reason. It's kind of the truth behind it. So when I was starting out working with desktops and with servers, I remember I was talking to a senior person, a senior system administrator that I was working with. And I told him, I said, well, what do you want to do later on in your IT field, in your career? He says, I want to be a network engineer. And I heard about that. And I said, well, why? And he said, I don't know, just the idea of connecting different networks together. And I thought about that for a long time after that conversation in the car. And for me, I realized something. That does sound very, very cool. That I can have a network in the United States, in New York, and a network in China. And I can have a network built that these two locations on the other side of the globe can communicate with each other. I thought that was fascinating. I really, really liked that idea of connecting different networks together to communicate. I thought that was fascinating. So I really fell in love with that. But I remember I was reading a particular article. This is a long time ago. Cisco used to have a magazine called Packet. It was a great magazine. I really loved it, but it became discontinued. I do not know why. It was a great magazine. I love that Cisco did it, but they stopped making it. But I remember there was a particular article that talked about basically satellites having Cisco routers. And my mind just went crazy because I said, that is why I love networking. Because for one of my hobbies is space. I am a big astronomer fanatic. I love space, physics, science. That's one of my big interests as well. And history. So the ability of saying, look, if we have routers within satellites, then we can have networking being extended from Earth up into space and then maybe up to the moon and to other planets. Now, it'd be a little bit tricky because the speed of light and light travel between the moon and even with Mars and even further, there's a lot of latency involved. But I think if you have like some optimization techniques, WAN optimization, caching, scalable data referencing, there's definitely ways of having communication happen from Earth to many parts within the solar system is definitely possible. Probably take a lot of working. But the point is that idea of that was completely fascinating. That was something I think that network engineers themselves will have a very, very strong footprint because something like that will happen. So that was something that I found interesting. But also another thing though that I really got into networking, because I liked it as well because of those components, but it was because of the support model. I quickly learned that when I was a system administrator, I got a lot of phone calls that things were down, servers are not responding, applications are having an issue, users can't connect to this particular service, but others can. And I remember getting a lot of phone calls as a system administrator, and I didn't like it. I said, if this is what IT is going to be, I don't like this though. So I didn't like that because I had this very simple philosophy that it should just work. Why is it having problems for it? Why should I have to reboot a server and it works automatically? That didn't make any sense to me though. So I quickly learned that in the networking field, the support model is a way lot lower though. You don't get a lot of phone calls for things like that. So that's something that I also really, really liked because I did not like how much servers. My wife, she works on servers right now. She still get phone calls. I'm sleeping soundly in my bed. I don't really get phone calls. She gets phone calls and she does servers. So I'm just saying. So that's one of my professional reasons of why I want to be a network engineer. Now, there's also a personal reason, and it's very, very quick, so I will share that with you though. For a long time, I'm not good at a lot of things. I don't play sports. I don't like sports. I'm not good at board games. I never really was good at anything until I got into networking. And I realized I was pretty good at it. I'm not saying I'm the expert, best person in the universe, but I was really good at what I did and I liked it. So once I figured out I was good at networking, I took full advantage of that opportunity. I got certified to the highest that I can, which is the CCIE. I basically outlined what jobs did I want. I said that I want to be a senior network engineer, I want to be a senior backbone engineer, that would be awesome, and I want to be a consultant and architect. I want to publish a technical book. I want to do a lot of things, and I accomplished everything that I wanted to do as a network engineer, and I feel very proud about that. So that's kind of why I really did networking because I found my calling, so to speak. I found something that I really, really liked, and I took full advantage of it.